विष्णुपादाय कृष्णकृष्णाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामी नमामि। नमस्ते सारस्वती देवे गौरवाणी आचार्ये निर्विशेष शून्यवादि पाश्चात्य देशकारिणि। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। देयर इज यू आर फेमिलियर विद द शिक्षाष्टका ऑफ चैतन्य महाप्रभु। हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू आर फेमिलियर, यू नो अबाउट इट एट लीस्ट। हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू आर नॉट फेमिलियर, हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू आर नॉट फेमिलियर विद शिक्षाष्टका। So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has written 8 verses called the Shikshashtaka. That's the only thing that he gave it in writing. Of course, he taught the whole philosophy of Krishna consciousness to all his disciples. But in writing, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu left behind 8 very important verses. And these 8 verses, it gives you the complete understanding of Krishna consciousness, right from beginning till the end. One of those verses, it's a very nice prayer. They are prayers to the Lord, to Krishna. The 4th verse, it says, Ai Nanda Tanuja Kinkaram. He's praying to the Supreme Lord. Ai Nanda Tanuja. Nanda Tanuja. Ai means oh. Nanda Tanuja, my dear son of Nanda, that is Krishna. Ai Nanda Tanuja Kinkaram. The first prayer is Kinkaram, I am your servant. This is what we must always remember. The very reason we are here in the material world is because we wanted to lord it over, we wanted to become the masters. And that's the reason why we were sent here in this material world. Because we cannot become the masters in the spiritual world. In this, our actual constitutional position is to be the servant. You know who becomes demigods, who becomes devatas? You all know about devatas, right? Indra, Brahma, so many different devatas are there. What qualifies you to become a devata? Pious activity, yes. There is one very special qualification that Prabhupada mentions by which you become a devata. 100 Ashwamedh Yagna. Yes, you may become if you... So do you want to become a devata, first of all? How many of you would like to become a devata and go to the topmost planet, Brahmaloka? Why you don't want to go? Because Brahma Bhuvana Loka Punaravarti, no Arjuna? Because if you go even to the topmost devata planet, you will go back, you will come down to this material world. So Prabhupada says, you become a devata when two things happen. Number one, you have a pure consciousness to serve the Supreme Lord. Not everybody can develop this desire. Pure, not contaminated, unadulterated. They have a pure consciousness to serve the Supreme Lord, but at the same time, they want to lord it over the material nature. So these devotees who have developed this desire to serve the Lord, intense desire, but at the same time want to lord it over the material nature, they are all given positions of devatas in the upper planetary system. Because they want to serve the Lord. So you serve the Lord by being one of the administrators and managing the entire material creation, but they want to lord it over, so that Devata position is very befitting, because in that position you can lord it over. It's like in the material world also we have examples, right? We are all doing different services. In our services also we have this, some of you will be having this realization. We all want to lord over even when we are serving the Supreme Lord, right? So when this lording over tendency does not go, you may still have the desire to serve the Lord. But as long as that lording over tendency doesn't go, you will never be promoted to the spiritual world. So as devotees, we are doing so much of service and we take pride in doing service, right? Yes, we must take pride. But we must remember that we must do our service very, very humbly. As long as we are doing service, imagine the devatas, they developed the pure consciousness to serve the Supreme Lord. Even then they couldn't go back to Godhead because of that contamination of wanting to lord it over in whatever service they are doing. See? But Krishna is very merciful. He gave them the position of, okay, become one of the devata. Indra, you become Indra, manage this thing. You become Varuna, manage this thing. You become Varuna. Varuna manages what? The entire ocean. He is the predominating deity of the ocean, the watery kingdom. There's a whole Garbhodakshai Vishnu sitting in the universe, and half of the universe is filled with water. You can imagine half of the universe is filled with water. What a huge ocean. It is just like, you know what is a drop of water when compared to the Atlantic Ocean, right? How small and big. Or that frog in the well, small well and Atlantic Ocean. In the similar way, Atlantic Ocean becomes like a well when compared to the Garbhodakshai Ocean. Maybe Atlantic Ocean will be smaller than a well when compared to the Garbhodakshai Ocean. And that Garbhodakshai Ocean, entire thing where Vishnu is lying, as Garbhodaka Vishnu, that whole watery kingdom, Varuna is in control of that. So like this, Devata also did not develop the pure desire. They did not get freed from this desire of lording it over. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is praying, Ai Nanda Tanuja Kinkaram. The first prayer he is saying, please remind me to be your servant also. Please free me from this tendency of becoming the Lord, becoming the Master. I should not become. Jive Swarup Hoy Nitya Krishna Das. Our constitutional position is to be eternally a dasa. Dasa means servant. So this is one very important thing that we must remember, even after taking up devotional service, how to give up this tendency to trying to lord over, trying to control things. Krishna, Ekala, Ishvara, Krishna. Krishna is the only controller. Can a servant lord over? By definition, what is the meaning of definition of a servant? Kinkaram. Servant means you only have to follow the orders of the master. If the servant is trying to lord over, trying to control, means what is the servant trying to become? The master. Prabhupada uses another very strong word, stronger than servant, just to stress on this point to his devotees that please remember, you are the servant, you are the servant, you are the servant. The first reason that we fell from the spiritual world was, I want to enjoy independent of Krishna. I want to be the master, just like Krishna is the master. So I wanted to enjoy like Krishna. That's the reason we fell down. And this whole material world, the life that we are going through, and the purification that we are going through, the spiritual practices that we are going through, our sadhana, bhakti, everything, finally, it is all to get rid of this ego, I am the master. And to be established in our constitutional position, Jive Swarupa Nitya Krishna Das. All the sadhana, bhajan, everything that we are doing, all these days, we have been doing and will continue to do, it is actually to make you free from this concept of lording over. So, servant. So I was telling, Prabhupada uses another very strong word just to stress on this point of servant. Can anybody say that? What is a stronger word than servant? Yes. Good. Prabhupada says, we are not servant, we are not just servants of Krishna, we are slaves of Krishna. Slave is a stronger word, right? A slave has still no more freedom. Servant may still have some freedom, right? But a slave is a slave. But this is not an ordinary slave. This is divine slavery. We are all actually slaves. If you are not, just like Prabhupada says, if you are not servant of Krishna, you are servant of what? Maya. In the same way, right now, if you don't accept the slavery of Krishna, you are actually accepting to be the slave of Maya and slave of your senses. Because right now the senses are controlling us, right? You do this, I am doing this. Mind is saying this, I am doing that. Eyes want to enjoy something, I am blindly following where my eyes want. Ears want to hear something, I am blindly following. So who? I am the slave of who? Senses. So if we say, if we tell devotees, you know, we are slaves of Krishna, they'll get a shock like this. Oh my God, you have become slaves of Krishna. But yes, this is better slavery, this is divine slavery than being slaves of these senses. So we are not just the servant, we are slaves. Prabhupada uses a still stronger word to indicate, to teach us that we are servant. You want to take one more try? A hint I'll give you. Now slavery is more stronger than servant. The next word that Prabhupada uses, the word may be not so strong, like the word slave is a stronger word than servant. The next word that Prabhupada uses is not a stronger word per se, but the meaning that that word indicates is even stronger. Dog. Yeah, dog is also in one way okay, but there's a different word that I have in mind. Menial servant, yes, that's a good word. But again, the servant is in. I'm looking for another word. The word may not be as strong, but the meaning that that word conveys is menial servant, dog, whatever you call it. So Prabhupada uses the word, we are all puppets in the hands of Krishna. You know what a puppet is, right? Has the puppet got any freedom? Servant and a slave may just, you know, slave is looking for how to escape. It may want to, you know, not follow your orders. But a puppet has actually no freedom at all. How the master is controlling the puppet? The puppet is forced to dance, to act according to the way the master is controlling. If the master lifts the right leg of the puppet's right leg will go up. The puppet cannot say, no, no, I don't want. Slave and master may sometimes, you know, refuse, but not a puppet. So Krishna is the puppet master. And we are all puppets of Krishna. We have absolutely no... So this is the consciousness that we should maintain, that I am a servant, I am a slave, I am a puppet in the hands of the Lord. And this is what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is praying in this verse. Anything that we do or we are doing for serving the Supreme Lord, we should think actually that I am just doing as a servant, as my master. Sometimes, you know, we do some great service, big service, and then we take a lot of pride in it. Or we become a little proud and we think that, again, what is coming inside? Lording over tendency has come in. The mastering tendency has come in. So, this consciousness is very important to maintain. How, while doing great services, nice services, how I can maintain this consciousness that I am the servant? I am not the servant, I am the slave, I am the puppet. And a very nice example is set by Ramananda Raya. Ramananda Raya, he was a great devotee of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He was the greatest devotee of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had branded him as the most elevated devotee. There are many instances which has happened in the life of Ramananda Rai in the Chaitanya Charitamrita that's mentioned, wherein Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, there is no one superior to you. He, Maya couldn't touch him. He could, you know, it is generally said for devotees, we should not associate with women. Ramananda Raya wouldn't get affected even by intimate association with women. That exalted devotee he was. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he would ask Ramananda Raya to talk about Radha Krishna. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would listen and enjoy the teachings, not the teachings, the talk given by Ramananda Raya. You see how great devotee he was? Instead of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu talking to Ramananda Raya, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would hear from Ramananda Raya about the pastimes of Radha Krishna. So that level Ramananda Raya was. But in spite of Ramananda Raya having attained that topmost position of telling Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, talking to him about transcendental pastimes of Radha Krishna, Ramananda Raya never got affected a bit about he is the master. He maintained this wonderful consciousness of puppet. And he said, he gave an example, he said that my mouth, whatever I am speaking, I am not speaking. Whatever is coming, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in your mind, is coming out through my mouth. You see, when you talk, actually something is happening in the mind. And then we speak. He's saying, I'm just a puppet. What I'm speaking is not my words. It's like a puppet. Has he got any independence? Right? The person is there and he's controlling the strings and that puppet is dancing. Similarly, when he's speaking, he's saying, it's not coming from my mind. All the exalted talks about Radha Krishna that I am giving is all coming, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Actually, it's all generating from your mind, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But it is coming out of my mouth. You're getting an idea? And he gave an example. He said, I am like the strings of the veena. And you are actually the veena player. I am the instrument and you are the player. When somebody is playing a veena or a sitar very beautifully, very nicely, you praise the sitar or the sitar player? Sitar player. Why don't you praise the sitar? Because sitar is dead. It's just like a, sitar is like a puppet. It depends totally on how that master, the sitar master, the veena master is playing. It is moving the strings. Accordingly, the sitar will produce the music. So he said, I am like that. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was praising him, oh Ramananda Raya, you are talking about pastime of Radha Krishna so nicely. But he said that, you know, I am just like a veena player. So this is the first instruction. Ai nanda tanuja kinkaram. I'm like a servant. That's one learning we get. In our prayers, we should always pray, I'm your servant. And second, Ai nanda tanuja kinkaram patita mam. The second teaching is patita. I am very, very fallen. Again, something similar, but this is what we must understand. We must maintain our consciousness in, I am very fallen. Never think that we are very great, we are very big. Spiritual life is a different life. In the material world, you are very great. Unless and until you prove your greatness, you prove your position in the material world, you cannot succeed in the material world, right? In the material world, you have to do this, you have to do that, you have to act this, you have to achieve that. But the spiritual, that is for material things. But the spirit, if you have to come out of this material entanglement, you have to be the reverse. Patitam, I am very fallen. The third verse of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is something similar. Trinagapi Shumi Chena. So we are very, very fallen. Prabhupada says, the more fallen you are, the more fallen you consider yourself to be, the greater advancement in spiritual life you will make. Whole spiritual life, the foundation is humility. Foundation is tolerance. Gopi Bhartu Pada Kamalayo Dasa Dasa. We are the most fallen servant of the servant of the servant. We are not just the servant of the servant of the servant, in that servant also I am most fallen. So this is another consciousness that we must maintain, that I am very fallen, never we should become puffed up in spiritual life. Whatever is happening, whatever good is happening, you should thank God that God, you know, I am actually so fallen, I do not deserve this. But you have still given me this. How merciful you are. You'll be able to very quickly realize the mercy of the Supreme Lord once you maintain this position of how fallen we are. So, Patitam ma vishame bhavam budhav. And I have fallen into this vishame bhavam budhav. Vishame means this dangerous. Bhava ambudhi. This dangerous ocean of material existence. So this third, what is the first point? First thing in the prayer? That I am the servant. Second thing, I am very fallen. And this material world is a dangerous ocean. Imagine if somebody just drops you into the Atlantic Ocean. What will happen? You're finished. In one place, Prabhupada is saying, the ocean waves are tossing, right? You've seen an ocean? It's always tossing. There are some waves on. So suppose you go to this ocean, you have fallen in the ocean. You try to stop the tossing of the waves. You try to make the ocean calm and peaceful by trying, you know, sometimes in a small bathtub, you see, there will be some little waves of water, right? And you try to make the waves of water, and the waves is disturbing you, right? So you try to make the water calm, you put your hand in it, so that there is no waves, it becomes very still. In a small bathtub, you can do that. Can you stop the tossing of the waves of the ocean? Prabhupada says, in the material world, people are trying to stop this tossing of the waves. And that is there. You can call it foolishness or you can call it madness. It's both foolishness and madness. Can we ever stop the tossing of the waves of an ocean? Not possible. Similarly, said na padam padam yat vipadam. This material world is Vishame Bhavam Budhav. It's an ocean of suffering and we cannot get rid of the suffering in this material world. This is the nature of the material world. So every moment we should remember that this is the nature of the material world. It's by nature Dukkhalayam Ashasvatam. It is Smara Nitya Anityatam. In one place it says, Smaran, Nitya. Nitya means always. Smaran, you should always remember what? Anityatam. The Anityatam means the temporary nature of this material world, which is full of suffering. So, you see, sometimes the desire to come out of a... unless and until you know that this place is a place of suffering, you will not develop detachment for it, right? If everything goes on very nicely in the material world, we will be very happily situated here. It's like in the prison house. Why do they give troubles? Why is there beatings and sufferings in the prison house? So then the prisoner realizes he has done a mistake and he works towards coming out of that prison house. So the same way we must remember that this material world is an ocean of suffering. I am fallen, and I have fallen into this material world, and I must come out of it quickly. And the spiritual world is so great, so exciting, so wonderful. That's the place where I must go. माम उपेत्य तो कौन्तेय पुनर्जन्म न विद्यते. You come back to me, no more पुनर्जन्म. That's what the place we want to go. But आ ब्रह्म भुवना लोका पुनरावर्ति न अर्चना. So, I nanda tanuja kinkaram, yes servant, patitam, I am fallen into this dangerous material world which is full of suffering. I nanda tanuja patitam maam vishme padam bhavamada kripaya tava pada pankaja. So because of all these things, now he is praying, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saying, kripaya, my request is tava pada pankaja. Please, tava pada pankaja, your pada means lotus feet, pada means feet, pankaja means lotus feet, tava pada pankaja, sthita dhuli sadrisham, just as a dhuli, as a small particle of dust. If you can place me at your lotus feet, vichintaya, and the mood of the prayer is very nice. He is not saying, he is not just only saying, please keep me at your lotus feet as a particle of dust, that's all that I want. He is saying, vichintaya, kripaya. First he says kripaya, he is requesting to keep me as a particle of dust at your lotus feet, and is saying vichintaya, you please think it over. If you want, you can do it. See, this is a surrendered nature of a devotee. Devotee is not saying, praying, Krishna, please keep me at your lotus feet. He's offering this prayer, so such a nice prayer, please keep me at your lotus feet, and then he's saying, vichintaya, you please think it over. See, such a nice mood it is. Like somebody comes and requests you, he gives you so many requests. But at the same time, this is the mood he has. You please think it over. Vichinta, aap chinta kari, agar ho sake to kari. So that also he doesn't, he's leaving it to the Lord. So in a state of pure humility, just before this previous verse is Istranada Bhishu Nichena, and soon after that this verse comes. So this is the mood in which he's offering a prayer. So it's a very nice prayer. He's saying that just keep me as a particle of dust at your lotus feet. That's all my request is. So a devotee is so humble, so fallen. If just this much position he can get, his life is successful. Dust is like worthless, right? It's got no meaning. So that is what he is. But that dust, if it can be at the lotus feet of the Lord, then that's a great position. So life after life, this is what our aspiration should be, how somehow to get a position, a small position at the lotus feet of the Lord, just as a dust, and then my life is successful. It's like the saffron, you have seen the saffron, a lotus flower. Inside the lotus flower, there is a saffron, and there is a saffron dust, right? And so similarly, the lotus flower is very beautiful. So his feet is also like a lotus feet. And just like a saffron, the dust of the saffron is at the lotus flower. Similarly, the devotee is saying, let me become a small dust at your lotus feet. And that's the only position I want. So it's a very nice prayer that we can offer. We should actually offer all the prayers are very wonderful. For those of you who haven't seen the Shikshashtaka prayers, you can go through it. They are beautiful prayers composed by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and you can chant them every day. And this specific prayer is also another very nice prayer, where these are the meditations that we can go through when we are chanting. I am a servant, I am very fallen. The position, the nature of this material world is, you know, Vishameva Mamada, it's an ocean of suffering. And my only request is somehow I be situated as a dust of your lotus feet. Hare Krishna. I don't want to extend, it's only 9:25. If you have any one or two questions, anybody has? Yes.
Do we all have the material desires also, and we are practicing Krishna consciousness also?
Yeah.
So, see, by the statement we can say, so we see our future and then we want.
Yeah. No, your future is not demigod. Your future is in the Goloka Vrindavan. So this is the process of purification. So the future will be a demigod if the process of purification is not complete. So this is the challenge. How to do a lot of service for the Lord, at the same time not develop that lording tendency. Maintain humility. So how does it come? It's a challenge that he's saying that we are all going through. Right? We are all doing a lot of service, but we are all realizing it becomes very difficult to get rid of this lording over tendency, trying to derive pleasure for our own self in what service we are doing. Pleasure for the Supreme Lord is good, but usually we try to derive pleasure for our own self. It gratifies our sense in doing all this big service. So how to be free from that? How to be basically free from this lording? How to be humble? So it's very, Prabhupada said this, the formula is very simple, there is no secret. You have to chant Hare Krishna attentively, respectfully, sincerely, hearing every word. There was one devotee of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who's a devotee who had leprosy on his entire body, leper Vasudev. There was a devotee, his name was Vasudev. He was filled with leprosy. I'll just tell it in short. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu knew he was actually a very great devotee. But his body was, you know, leprosy. Whole body is filled with worms, with leprosy wound. And worms were all sitting on his body. Nobody would even go near him. So once he heard that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was coming to visit him, to visit that place. And because of his body was so much diseased, he didn't want to, you know, somehow didn't want Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to come and touch him because he was concerned that he's the Supreme Lord, he shouldn't get contaminated like that. He was a very exalted devotee. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu knew his mind. He was a very nice devotee. So it so happened that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and he wanted to embrace him, and he was not wanting Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to embrace him because he knew his whole body is filled with leprosy. There was oozing pores, wet sores on his body. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu nevertheless went and embraced him nicely. And the moment Chaitanya Mahaprabhu embraced him, immediately entire leprosy from his body went away. It just vanished like magic. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And not just his entire body leprosy vanished, he regained a very nice, beautiful body. So then, this Vasudev prayed, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked him, do you have any desires? Because he cured him. He cured the leper immediately, instantly. So, if you have any other desires, I'll fulfill. So this Vasudev leper, he said, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I have no desires. You know, you have, by your transcendental touch, you have completely healed me. And now I'm afraid that I'll become very proud. What will be my pride? That I have received, I am the recipient of the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. No, it's a very thing to be proud of, right? I am the recipient, and it's a very gross thing which everybody can see and make out. That I am the recipient of the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Just by his touch, I got completely cured. So he says, my prayer is, please tell me a formula, please tell me how this pride will not come in me. What will prevent me from becoming proud that I am the recipient of your mercy? So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Sada Hari Nama Japa. He says, always chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, and if you are always chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, pride will not touch you. So this is what our formula is. You have to just go on chanting Hare Krishna Mantra and wait for that time for purification. The purification, actually, by chanting one mantra, purification can happen. Eka Hari Name Jato Paap Dharita. The one holy name, it is said, you know how much sins one holy name can counteract? Hare or Krishna. How much sin can one name Krishna counteract? Who can tell? 10 life? One holy name, I'm saying, just Krishna. How much sin can one Krishna counteract? 10 life? 100 life? We are chanting 16 rounds every day. That is how many? About 1700 holy names every day we are chanting. It is said, one aka hori name, joto paap hore, paapi hoy toto paap koi bare nare. One holy name, Krishna alone, can counteract so many sinful activities, so many sinful reactions that an expert papi, an expert sinner, cannot commit that much pap. That much pap, one holy name can counteract. So you see the potency, the strength of one holy name. So where is pride in front of holy names? So for this, we have to chant attentively. We have to be hearing every mantra. This is the most important thing. We should not take our chanting to be an official 16 rounds completing. No. While chanting, only three things should be going on. One, chant loudly. Second, chant clearly. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Clearly. Not like this. Don't speed it up. Don't worry about the speed. Most important thing is quality chanting. Everything depends on your chanting. Your whole spiritual life depends upon your chanting. So chant loudly, chant clearly, and third thing, hear attentively. These three things, if you are conscious of, chanting loudly, chanting clearly, chanting attentively, you are on a very safe position. And if you are not doing these three things during your chanting, loudly, clearly, attentive hearing, then we need to work on our chanting seriously. Chanting is very simple, but the practice is difficult. The practice is where we are failing. Prabhupada says, the chanting is very simple. What is there in chanting? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Then what is the difficulty? The difficulty is we are not serious practitioners of the chanting. And that serious practicing comes with loud chanting, clear chanting, attentive hearing. So you do these three things and then automatically all the anarthas will go away, the lording over tendency will go away, you may be doing big, big service, still you will always remember that you are servant, you are slave, you are puppet of the Supreme Lord. So that's the last question.
For a beginner, you recited this instruction. For a beginner, the first objective should be to chant 16 rounds rather than focusing on the immediate instruction that you gave. Is it?
Which immediate instruction?
Like clear chanting and very chanting. So first objective is to be to chant 16 rounds for a beginner.
See, this objective of chanting clearly, chanting loudly and hearing, this in no way is a, it will complement your 16 rounds. In fact, from day one, you should chant your 16 rounds, definitely. But how does this instruction in no way is trying to hinder the 16 round chanting? So in fact, right from the beginning, this should be the consciousness, so that going forward, if we don't have this thing in mind right from the beginning, what will happen as you go forward? Our 16 rounds will become like an official chanting. So even if you chant one round or two round, we should always be stressing on good chanting. 16 rounds is important. Quality is also important. Both are important. And neither one hinders the other. Right? If you're chanting one round, you chant with these things. If you're chanting 16, whatever rounds you're chanting, keep this. Both are parallel. Both can happen together. So right from the beginning, we should be always thinking of good chanting, quality chanting. There are many instructions of Prabhupada where he has written letters to devotees who have just taken initiation or who have just not even taken initiation. Prabhupada is talking about quality chanting. If you look at Prabhupada's instructions, 1966 he went to America. From 1966 onwards, you have innumerable instructions of Prabhupada where he is stressing on the, he is focusing, he is stressing on the quality of chanting, good chanting. Because chanting is our life and soul. The first instruction, the first verse of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you know, Cheto Darpanam Archanam Anandam Budhi Vardhanam Pratipadam, you will merge into an ocean of ecstasy. All this shows that chanting has to be taken very seriously. So, chanting has to be taken seriously is what I am trying to say.
If someone says, like, people say, charam karo, like, nachche se karo, they want, don't want to move further. Because basically,
no. Yeah, you have to move further because 16 rounds is like the 5 regulative principles, they say. 4 regulative principles and the 5th regulative principle is chanting 16 rounds. But as I said, you should not be stuck, मैं चार ही करूँगा, अच्छे से करूँगा, और ज़्यादा नहीं करूँगा. नहीं, आपको 16 करना है, लेकिन सारे 16 अच्छे से करने हैं. क्योंकि कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ता है ना, टाइम वही लगेगा. करीब 7.5-8 मिनट. उसी टाइम में कोई एक्स्ट्रा टाइम नहीं लगेगा. उसी टाइम पे आप कर सकते हैं.